Let's discuss about ideal regenerative Rankine cycle in this discussion. So the ideal regenerative cycle is just an improvement for the normal Rankine cycle to increase its thermal efficiency. So in regenerative Rankine cycle, we take the condensate which comes out of the pump and we send the condensate into the turbine casing. So wherein the condensate absorbs heat energy from the steam turbine casing and becomes preheated. Let's look into the schematic diagram for ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. So this is the ideal regenerative Rankine cycle, so which is shown on the screen. See here, this is the boiler. From the boiler, the steam is coming out at state 1. And it is expanding inside the steam turbine till state 2 dash. From 2 dash it is entering the condenser, so wherein it rejects heat energy and gets condensed and comes out at state 3, then enters the pump. So the pump pumps the condensate at state 4 into the steam turbine casing. The condensate flows into the steam turbine casing by absorbing heat energy from the steam turbine casing, becomes hot, then comes out at state 5. Then the condensate at state 5 then enters the boiler at the boiler pressure, against the boiler pressure. So inside the boiler, the condensate absorbs Q1 amount of heat energy, then it comes out at state 1. Thus the cycle gets completed in ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. Now let's look into the TS diagram for this ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. Its temperature is plotted on y-axis and entropy is plotted on x-axis. So here, as usual, we know that this is the vapor dome. See here, the steam at from the boiler at state 1 enters the steam turbine. It undergoes expansion. See, if condensate is not passed into the turbine casing, the steam undergoes isentropic expansion and it expands through the process line 1 to 2. But in ideal regenerative Rankine cycle, this is not the case. The condensate is being passed through the turbine casing. So because of that, the steam is losing heat energy. So due to that, the temperature of the steam decreases. So hence the entropy also reduces. So because of that reason, the steam follows the path 1 to 2 dash, means there is a decrease in temperature as well as there is a reduction in entropy during this process. So it will not follow 1 to 2 process. So from 2 dash, the steam enters the condenser and undergoes condensation by rejecting Q2 amount of heat energy. So then the steam becomes saturated liquid. So the condensate at state 3 enters the pump, so wherein it is pumped between 3 and 4 against the boiler pressure. Then the condensate at state 4 then enters the steam turbine casing, as we have seen in schematic diagram. So this is the condensate at state 4 entering the steam turbine, absorbing heat energy, then coming out at state 5 with high temperature. So the same process, so we can see on the TS diagram, that is from 4 to 5. So it is heating inside the steam turbine casing. So the condensate at state 5 then enters the boiler. So wherein inside the boiler, so we are adding heat energy Q1. We are adding heat energy Q1 inside the boiler. So by absorbing Q1 amount of heat energy, then the steam again comes to original state. So that is state 1. So here this is the TS diagram for ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. So here 1 to 2 dash indicates the area covered below the process, 1 to 2 dash. So then again the area covered below the process 3, 4, 5, both areas are same on the TS diagram. Now on this diagram, we are supplying heat energy Q1 between 5 and 1, so that is Q1 here, and again we are rejecting the heat energy between 2 dash and 3, that is Q2 on this diagram. Now the heat transfer takes place from the vapor to the condensate as it flows through the turbine casing. Let's understand about the process 1 to 2 which 1 to 2 dash which represents a reversible expansion of steam in the turbine with reversible heat rejection. So we understood from the TS diagram, so because of heat rejection to the condensate, it follows the process 1 to 2 dash instead of 1 to 2. So now here on this line, the heat gained by the water means there is a rise in temperature of the water during the process 4 to 5. So if you consider the change in the temperature during the process temperature, small finite change in the temperature, that is delta T of the water, which is equal to the change in the temperature of the steam. And we consider it as an ideal process of a heat exchange inside the turbine casing. And again, the entropy of the water and entropy, change in entropy of the steam, are also same on this TS diagram. So now let's understand about the process. Slopes of the lines 1 to 2 dash and 3 to 5 on this diagram will be identical. So that is on TS diagram, the slope of this line 1 to 2 dash as well as 3 to 5, so the slope of these two lines both remains same. So now here the areas, as we have just now discussed, these areas, the area 4 5 ba 4, that is this area, and one more area is 2 dash 1 dc 2. So this area hatched portions both are equal on this TS diagram. So now all heat added to the external source is Q1. It is added at the temperature T1, so that is the boiler temperature is T1 and the condenser temperature is T2. Heat is rejected at T2, Q2 is rejected at T2, and both are reversible processes. Now let's discuss about the ideal regenerative Rankine cycle efficiency. So how to derive it? So here in this cycle, Q1 is the amount of heat supplied into the cycle. So we are supplying the heat energy between 5 and 1, that is state 5 and 1. This is the heat supply process, so wherein we are supplying the heat energy. So therefore the temperature is T1, that is height, and again the change in entropy is S1 minus S5. So this is the area covered below the process 5 to 1. So this represents Q1. The same expression that we can write as Q1 is equal to H1 minus H5, that is T1 into S1 minus S5. So similarly, we are rejecting heat energy between 2 dash and 3 on the TS diagram. 2 dash and 3 here, between 2 dash and 3 we are rejecting heat energy. So the temperature here is T2 and the change in entropy is S2 dash minus S3 it is. So this is the area of heat rejection. So therefore Q2 we can write it as T2 times S2 dash minus S3. So the same formula is written over here, that is Q2 is equal to S2 dash minus S3 into T2 into S2 dash minus S3. So here, friends, let's understand S5 minus S3 is equal to S1 minus S2 dash. So it can be written from the TS diagram. Let's understand S5 minus S3, that is the entropy at state 5. This is S5 minus S3, so which is equal to S1 minus S2 dash. So both the length on the x-axis, that is entropy axis, being the same, we can write this expression from this TS diagram as S5 minus S3 is equal to S1 minus S2 dash. So from this we can get the Rankine cycle efficiency. We know that it is 1 minus Q2 upon Q1, that is heat rejection upon heat supplied. So if you simplify, you will get regenerative Rankine cycle as 1 minus T2 upon T1, so which is almost equal to the Carnot cycle efficiency. So this is the Carnot cycle efficiency, 1 minus T2 upon T1. So then again, here we can discuss about the limitations of this ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. So it is, even though very efficient cycle and having highest thermal efficiency, this cycle cannot be used practically in steam turbine plants. Let's understand. So why we can't use this steam turbine cycle, that is a regenerative cycle? First one is reversible heat transfer cannot be obtained in finite time. So where the reversible heat transfer is happening? So a reversible heat transfer is happening between steam and water, that is 1 to 2 dash the steam is losing its heat energy, and between 3 and 5 water is condensate is gaining the heat energy. That heat transfer is happening and it is a reversible heat transfer. So it should it is not possible to obtain it in a proper time. So then again, heat exchanger in a turbine is mechanically impracticable. So the heat exchanger means the heat exchange process is happening between condensate and steam turbine casing. So it is because of a heat exchanger, so that is mechanically it is not practicable to obtain the desired results. And third one is moisture content of the steam inside the turbine is high. So we have seen from the TS diagram, the steam is not superheated at the turbine inlet. So it is saturated steam which enters the saturated vapor steam, so which enters the steam turbine. So hence moisture is present as it is flowing through the turbine. So these are the limitations of this ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. So because of these reasons, it is not practicable to use in the steam turbine plants. So therefore, in practice, so we use a regenerative feed water heating by bleeding a small quantity of steam from the turbine and use this steam to heat the feed water in a feed water heater. Let's look into this one. So how we can achieve this point, that is heating inside the feed water heater. See, the regenerative Rankine cycle with the open feed water heater. So this is the schematic arrangement for this cycle. So how we can heat the feed water with the help of the steam which is bled from the steam turbine casing. Let's understand here. For this cycle, the steam enters the turbine at state 1 and undergoes expansion inside the steam turbine. So while the steam is expanding inside the steam turbine, so the part of steam, small quantity of steam is bled from this turbine casing, and it is taken at state 2 and it is sent in a open feed water heater. Then the remaining steam after bleeding at state 2, then it further undergoes expansion inside this steam turbine. So then it comes out of the steam turbine at state 3. So then it enters the condenser, so wherein it rejects heat energy into the atmosphere. So then further the condensate which comes out of the condenser enters the pump 1 here. So this pump pumps the condensate at state 5, condensate at state 5 into the feed water heater against the pressure at state 2, because the pressure of the steam is high, because it is a steam was bled from the steam turbine. So against that pressure, pump 1 has to work. So wherein the inside the feed water heater, the condensate and the steam both gets mixed and heat is added to the condensate. So then the condensate at a state 6, that is with high temperature, it comes out. So then we use pump 2 to pump this condensate at state 7 into the boiler. So inside the boiler again it absorbs heat energy, so then comes out at state 1. So this is how the open feed water heater is used in a regenerative Rankine cycle. The same schematic diagram can be drawn for the purpose of writing in exams as this way. So here this is the boiler or steam generator, so wherein it the steam comes out at state 1, undergoes expansion. So then in WT1 it undergoes expansion, then at a state until state 2. So from state 2, a small quantity of steam is bled from the turbine casing and sent into the open feed water heater at state 2. Then the remaining steam undergoes expansion inside the remaining stages of the turbine. Then the steam comes out at state 3. So then it enters condenser. From condenser it comes out at state 4. So from 4 it enters pump 1. So from pump 1 at state 5 it again enters the feed water heater. So open feed water heater, so both steam as well as condensate both mix physically and comes out at state 6, then enters the pump 2. So then pump 2 pumps the condensate at state 7 into the boiler. So boiler adds a Q1 amount of heat energy. So then the steam comes out at state 1. So this is how the open feed water heater functions. So this is the schematic diagram and TS diagram for open feed water heater. So we'll discuss this in the further videos, thermal analysis of this cycle. Now let's look into regenerative Rankine cycle with open feed water heater. Few important points related to this cycle. So as we understood, the steam is extracted from the turbine at various points, and this steam is used to heat the feed water coming from the condenser. The device where feed water is heated by regeneration is called a regenerator. So the device wherein regeneration is carried out, regeneration in the sense, take bleeding the steam from the steam turbine and using that steam to preheat the feed water, that is called as a regeneration process, and the device is called as feed water heater. So now here the feed water is basically a heat exchanger. Feed water heater, what is that? It is a basically heat exchanger wherein heat is transferred from steam to the feed water either by mixing two fluids. So we saw in the open feed water heater the two streams, that is the steam which is coming out of the turbine as well as the condensate, so which is coming from the pump. So both are physically mixed as a two fluid streams. Such a feed water heater is called as open feed water heater, and it is possible for us to heat the condensate without mixing the steam. So such type of feed water heater is called as a closed feed water heater. So now if you look into the image shows open feed water heater. Here the the steam which is coming from the steam turbine is entering, and this is the condensate which is entering here. So both physically gets mixed inside this open feed water heater. So then the mixture comes out. Such type of feed water heater is called as a open feed water heater. So now here let's understand one more type, so that is closed feed water heater. So if you look into this, the steam which is coming from the steam turbine casing, blood steam, and flows around the bunch of tubes inside the closed feed water heater. The condensate, so which is coming out of the pump from the condenser, enters this open closed feed water heater, and the condensate flows inside the tubes, and outside the tubes the steam, blood steam, is flowing. The steam gives away its heat energy to the tubes, so tubes in turn heat the condensate. So then again the steam, after rejecting its heat energy to the condensate, gets condensed again. Then this liquid water again it will be utilized in the cycle. So the same diagram can be represented in the form of line diagram as shown in the figure. So that is feed water in, so it is flowing inside the tubes, feed water out, outside the tubes extracted steam or blood steam from the steam turbine is flowing. So then it gets condensed, the condensate is pumped again into the cycle. So this is how closed feed water heater works. So now if you look into the schematic arrangement for regenerative Rankine cycle with closed feed water heater, so this is the schematic diagram that we can understand. So as you know, this is the boiler, so the steam comes out of the boiler, then undergoes expansion inside the steam turbine. A part of steam is bled and it is sent to the closed feed water heater. The remaining steam undergoes expansion, it enters the condenser. So after condenser, pump 1 pumps the condensate again. But condensate is flowing inside the tubes. The bled steam undergoes condensation, and this bled steam is entering the pump 2. The pump 2 pumps the condensate into a mixing chamber. So wherein the hot condensate and steam is coming, both gets mixed, but not in the feed water heater, but it is separately in a mixing chamber. Then the mixture again enters the boiler. So this is how the cycle completes for this. The same process can be represented on a schematic diagram that we discuss in textbooks. So this is the boiler. So steam at state 1 enters, undergoes expansion in the first stage. Then the steam at state 2 is bled. The remaining steam undergoes expansion inside the turbine. Then condenser, from condenser it enters a pump. So from pump it is flowing through the closed feed water heater here. So then the steam, bled steam, undergoes condensation. Again a pump is used to pump it into the cycle. The feed water then enters the boiler, comes out at state 1. So this is how the closed feed water heater works, and this is the corresponding temperature entropy diagram. So this is about our discussion in this lecture. Let's have a quick review. We discussed about ideal regenerative Rankine cycle schematic diagram as well as TS diagram. So we derived the expression for ideal regenerative Rankine cycle, so which was almost like Carnot cycle efficiency, and we discussed about limitations of ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. So then to overcome these difficulties, so we also discussed that regenerative feed water heater can be used. So then again we discussed and we understood about functioning of open feed water heater as well as closed feed water heater. So thank you. If you have any queries, please feel free to contact me. Thank you.